Human Fluid Analysis. Indications: number 1, establishing an accurate diagnosis of disease observable. Number 2, therapeutic transfusion. Methods of collection: number 1, stomach tube. Number 2, needle puncture of the woman. Number 3, Roman fistula. Number 4, Roman synthesis. The most common used method is the stomach tube. Roman fluid sample should be analyzed as soon as possible. Estimation of ammonia and chloride can be delayed up to 9 hours at room temperature and 24 hours on a refrigerated sample. Roman fluid analysis include physical, chemical, and microscopic analysis. The physical analysis includes the color, consistency, odor, and activity test. The chemical analysis include measuring the pH, methylene blue reduction test, cellulose digestion test, glucose fermentation test, nitrate reduction test, Roman fluid chloride. Microscopic analysis include qualitative and quantitative analysis. Physical examination: number 1, color. Normal color of the Romanal fluid varies according to the time of feed. It is greenish in color in case of green fooder, olive in color in cases of hay, and yellowish brown in color in cases of grains. The abnormal color include darker greenish in cases of prolonged ruminal stasis, milky in color cases of ruminal acidosis, gray with clot of milk, especially in calves, as a result of failure of the esophageal groove to close or due to abomasal reflux. Number 2, consistency. Normal consistency of the ruminal fluid is slightly viscous. The abnormal watery or frothy. Watery in cases of prolonged stasis of the ruminal fluid or inactive ruminal microbe. Frothy occur in cases of ruminal tympany. Number 3, odor. Normal odor is aromatic due to presence of volatile fatty acids in the rumen. The abnormal odor is sour, as in cases of ruminal acidosis. Ammonia odor in cases of ruminal alkalosis, putrefactive, as in cases of prolonged ruminal stasis. Sedimentation activity test: mixed ruminal juice sample is allowed to stand in a test tube for 4 to 8 minutes at room temperature. Normally, fine particles will sediment in the tube and the coarse particle will float to the top with clear fluid in between. This usually occurs within 4 to 8 minutes and indicate normal ruminal fluid. Abnormal sedimentation activity test, which may be rapid and occur in cases of inactive ruminal microbe, where fine particles at the bottom, no coarse particles at the top, and this occur before 4 minutes. Delayed sedimentation, which occur in cases of vagal indigestion or tympany, which associated with very active ruminal microfauna. Very rapid sedimentation with no flotation occurs in cases of ruminal acidosis, prolonged anoxia, inactive microflora from indigestible roughage. No appreciable sedimentation or flotation occur in cases of frothy blood and some cases of vagal indigestion. Chemical examination includes pH. Normally, the pH of the ruminal fluid from 6 to 7 in animal fed on roughage and from 5.5 to 6 in animal fed on considerable amount of grains. The pH is elevated to and become ruminal alkalosis in cases of simple indigestion, urea indigestion, putrefaction of rumen intestine, feeding on indigestible raw fish. Lowered pH or rumen acidosis occur in cases of engorgement with digestible carbohydrate, chronic rumen acidosis, abomasal reflux from abomasal disease, vagal indigestion, and intestinal obstruction. Number 2, methylene blue reduction test, which measure the ability of ruminal microbe to reduce methylene blue. 15 ml mixed ruminal juice sample is mixed with 1 ml 0.03% methylene blue in a test tube and allow it to stand at room temperature for 3 minutes. Normally, there is a decolorization of the methylene blue, which is returned to normal, and after 3 minutes, within 3 minutes, and this indicates the ruminal microbe able to reduce the methylene blue, and this in case of normal ruminal fluid. However, in cases of abnormal ruminal fluid due to inactive ruminal microbe, as in cases of presence of disease of the rumen, no reduction occur in methylene blue, and the color of the methylene blue remains the same after 3 minutes. Abnormal reduction of time up to 15 minutes indicate indigestible raw fishes, anorexia of several days, rumen acidosis. Number 3, cellulose digestion test measures the ability of ruminal microfauna to digest the cellulose. 10 ml strained and mixed ruminal juice sample is mixed with 0.3 ml 16% glucose in a test tube. Then a thread of pure cellulose, to which at the end there is a glass bead. Then stopper the tube from the above and leave the tube at 39 degrees centigrade for 48 hours. After that, normally the ruminal microfauna digest the cellulose and the glass bead fall down to the bottom of the tube. This normally occurs within 48 hours. This is normal. Abnormal condition, in cases of presence of disease of the rumen, the cellulose thread remain the same after the 24 hours. Glucose fermentation test, which measures the ability of ruminal microbe to ferment glucose. 10 ml strained and mixed ruminal juice sample is mixed with 0.5 ml 16% glucose and in the saccharometer, allow it to stand for 1 hour at 39 degrees centigrade. Normally, gases formed in the saccharometer, which is measured from 1 to 2 ml per hour. The normal rate of gas formation is 1 to 2 ml per hour. If the microbial flora is inactive, little or no gas will be formed. In foamy blood, more gas is formed with pronouncing foaming. Nitrate reduction test, which measure the ability of the ruminal microbe to reduce the nitrate. 3 test tubes are required for this test, to which 10 ml mixed ruminal juice sample is added, and then add potassium nitrate in a concentration of 0.25% in the first tube at 0.2 ml, the second tube 0.5 ml, third tube 0.7 ml. The tubes are allowed to stand in a water bath at 39 degrees centigrade. After 5 minutes, a drop from the fluid is put in a ceramic plate, to which a reagent is added. The result is that red color indicate presence of nitrate. The presence of nitrate indicate that the Romner microbe unable to reduce the material. However, normally no red color is formed. Chloride level, it is measured in the sewer net and of a centrifuged Romner fluid sample. Determination is done by using the chloride meter or spectrophotometer. Normal Romner fluid chloride concentration is less than 30 milli equivalent per liter. Elevated chloride level in the rumen suggests abomasal disease or suggests abomasal reflux or obstruction of the intestinal flow, which means that the content of the abomasum return to the rumen, which result in increase in the chloride level in the rumen. The chloride level in the rumen is used to differentiate between ruminal acidosis occur due to high concentrate in the ration and between ruminal acidosis occur due to abomasal reflux. The presence of high chloride level in the rumen indicate abomasal reflux. Some other tests for evaluation of the digestive activity of the rumen microflora include measurement of volatile fatty acids, measurement of lactic acid, measurement of ammonia, determination of concentration of sodium, potassium, determination of activity of enzymes. Microscopical examination include qualitative and quantitative analysis. The qualitative examination for the ruminal protozoa, which is the motility test. Simply put a drop from a well mixed and strained ruminal fluid sample on a glass slide and put a cover slide and then examine under the low dry power for the motility and the groundedness of the ruminal microbe. Highly motile and very crowded ruminal microbe take the 3+, motile and crowded take 2+, sluggish motility and low in number take 1+, no or sporadic alive fauna take 0. Both the first and the second is a normal ruminal microfauna. However, the sluggish motility, no number or no motility at all, and the sporadic fauna indicates the presence of disease of the rumen. The quantitative analysis include counting of the rumen microfauna, 5 milli strained and mixed ruminal juice sample is mixed with 20 milli Logol's iodine solution in a test tube. After that, 0.1 milli or 100 microliter from the mixture is applied on a glass slide covered with a cover glass. Count the ruminal microfauna, insert the field under low power objective, and then divide the obtained number by 30 and then multiply in 1100 and multiply also in 50 to obtain the count of ruminal microfauna per cubic millimeter. In cases of rumen function disturbances, large species of microfauna disappear firstly, followed by medium and finally the small species. The entire microfauna dies during severe digestive disorders, particularly when pH falls below 5. In recent cases of moderate digestive disorders, there is an increase in the proportion of dead to live protozoa. In addition to the ruminal microfauna, the ruminal fluid contain also bacteria and fungi. The concentration of the bacteria varies between 10 times 7 and 10 times 12 per milli of fluid rumen content or per gram of solid content. Fewer bacteria are present when a ration is rich in cellulose composed with a ration rich in starch. Fungi. are present as yeasts or candida. Such microorganisms are sometimes present in exceptional number during rumen acidosis. In a summary, a ruminal fluid sample is collected using stomach tube or through needle puncture or through a rumen fistula or through ruminosynthesis. The most common used method is stomach tube. The examination of the ruminal fluid includes physical, chemical, and microscopical. The physical examination includes the color, odor, consistency, and sedimentation activity time. The chemical method includes the pH, methylene blue reduction test, cellulose digestion test, nitrate reduction test, glucose fermentation test, and measuring the chloride level in the ruminal fluid. Microscopical analysis include qualitative and quantitative exam. The qualitative analysis include the motility test, motility of the ruminal microfauna, and the quantitative exam include counting of the ruminal microfauna in the ruminal fluid.